牧师，各位弟兄姐妹们，大家主里平安。欢迎大家参加今早的主日崇拜。我们开始今早的主日崇拜，在四月的时候，请大家以一颗安静的心，在主面前默祷等候。Pastor, brothers and sisters, greetings to you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. As we commence this morning's worship, let's all prepare our hearts in silent prayer during the prelude and wait upon the Lord. Let things be still for the presence of the Lord.诸天述说神的荣耀，穹苍传扬他的作为，天天发出言语，夜夜传出知识。没有话语，没有言辞，人也听不到他们的声音。他们的声音传遍全地，他们的言语传到地极。神在他们中间为太阳安设帐幕，太阳如同新郎出洞房，又像勇士欢欢喜喜地跑路。他从天这边出来，绕行到天的那边，没有什么可以隐藏，得不到他的温暖。请会众一同站立，我们唱十里诗歌，在十架上我救主舍命。Let's all stand and sing the opening hymn, Down at the Cross.
On the cross, I saved my life. On the cross, I saved my life. On the cross, I saved my life. 荣耀归主名，荣耀归主名，荣耀归主名。主奇妙恩，我一生难忘。荣耀归主名，我紧靠主有无限平安，有主是常住在我心内。如此茫然，我实在不配。荣耀归主名，荣耀归主名，荣耀归主名。主奇妙恩，我一生难忘。荣耀归主名。O precious fountain that saves from sin, I am so glad I have wasted it. There Jesus says, meet and kiss me clean. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. There to my heart was the blood applied. Glory to his name.
会众让我们继续站立，我们同心祷告。Let's continue standing and we pray.亲爱的天父上帝，我们感谢你丰盛的恩典，让我们再一次能够来敬拜你、服侍你。主，你是伟大和蛮有能力的神，是配得一切荣耀和赞美。Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your wonderful grace that we can come before you to worship you and to serve you. Oh Lord, you are worthy of all our honor and praises, as you are such a great and mighty God. 主啊，你是蛮有怜悯有恩典的神，不轻易发怒，并有丰盛的慈爱和诚实。我们一切的好处都不在你以外，在你面前我们有满足的喜乐，在你右手中有永远的福乐。 Lord, you are a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger, abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness. Lord, we have no good apart from you. In your presence there is fullness of joyAt your right hand are pleasures forevermore. 主啊，我们人算什么？你仅顾念我们。世人算什么？你仅眷顾他。我们原是不配的罪人，我们都如羊走迷，个人偏行己路，走向灭亡的道路。但你却因着爱，差遣你独生爱子耶稣基督，道成肉身，为了我们的罪钉在十字架上。让我们的罪得以赦免，从罪中被拯救出来。我们因你受的刑罚，我们得平安；因你受的鞭伤，我们得医治。Lord, what is man that you are mindful of him, and the Son of Man that you care for him? We are unworthy sinners. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, walking down the path of destruction.Yet you, out of love, sent your begotten Son, Jesus Christ, to become flesh, to bear our sins on the cross, so that in order to forgive our sins and to save us from iniquity. Lord, we thank you that the punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. Lord, 我们祈求你赦免我们一切的过犯，再次愿主耶稣基督在十字架上为我们所流的宝血洗净我们一切的罪。让我们能守节清心地来到你面前来敬拜你。Lord, we ask for your forgiveness of our sins and once again cleanse us from all unrighteousness with the precious blood shed by our Lord Jesus Christ on the cross. But we come before you with clean hands and pure hearts to worship you. 愿圣灵把会师在我们中间赐给我们智慧，好让我们能明白真道。求你帮助我们把你的话藏在我们心里，免得我们得罪你。May the Holy Spirit, the Counselor, be among us, granting us wisdom, so that we may understand the truth. Please help us to store your word in our hearts, so that we may not sin against you. 我们要把今早的崇拜仰望交托，求你赐给王牧师智慧，让他所讲的信息是你的心意，也让我们得到帮助。We commit this morning worship unto you.Please grant wisdom to Reverend Juan so that the message he preaches may be according to your will and may it be also beneficial to us. 我们如此祷告是奉主耶稣名求的。We pray this in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. 会众仍然站立，我们来坚定我们的信仰，我们同念使徒信经。Let's remain standing to recite the Apostles' Creed to affirm our faith. You can use your preferred language to recite.我信上帝全能的父，创造天地的主。我信我主耶稣基督，上帝的独生子，因圣灵感孕，由童贞女玛利亚所生，在本丢比拉多手下受难，被钉十字架，受死埋葬，降在阴间， 第三天从死人中复活，升天，坐在全能父上帝的右边，将来必从那里降临，审判活人死人。我信圣灵，我信圣的公之教会，我信圣徒相通，我信罪得赦免，我信身体复活，我信永生。阿们。会众请坐 ，Please be seated。今早的信息经文取自出埃及记第20章第一节到17节。翻到了，请听我来宣读主的话。This morning's scripture reading is taken from the book of Exodus, chapter 20, verses 1 to 17. Please listen to me as I read from the scripture. 神吩咐以下这一切话说：我是耶和华你的神，曾经把你从埃及地，从为奴之家领出来。除我以外，你不可有别的神，不可为自己做偶像，也不可做天上地下和地底下水中 各物的形象，不可跪拜他们，也不可侍奉他们，因为我耶和华你们的神是祭血的神，恨恶我的，我必追讨他们的罪，从父亲到儿子直到三四代，爱我和遵守我诫命的，我必向他们施慈爱直到千代。不可妄称耶和华你神的名，因为妄称耶和华的名的，耶和华必不以他为无罪。要纪念安息日，守为圣日，六日要劳碌做你一切工作，但第七日是耶和华你的神的安息日。这一日，你和你的儿女、你的仆婢和牲畜，以及住在你城里的寄居者，不可做任何的工。因为耶和华在六日之内造天地海和其中的万物，第七日就歇息了。所以耶和华赐福安息日，定为圣日。要孝敬父母，使你在耶和华你的神所赐给你的地上得享长寿。不可杀人，不可奸淫，不可偷盗，不可作假见证陷害你的邻舍，不可贪爱你邻舍的东西房屋，不可贪爱你邻舍的妻子、仆婢、牛驴和他任何的东西。这是上帝的话语，我们应当感谢上帝。 This is the word of God. Let's give thanks to God for his word. 今早上帝要透过王牧师来传讲他的话语。王牧师要传讲的信息是十诫，让我们以一颗谦卑的心来聆听。 The title that Reverend Juan is going to preach this morning is the Ten Commandments. Let's listen to the sermon with humble heart. 我们请王牧师。
好，亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，主里平安。
Peace be with you, dear brothers and sisters.
欢迎大家来到我们当中，一同的来崇拜我们的上帝。
Welcome everyone to come together to worship our Lord God.
让我们一起来做一个祷告好吗
？Let's pray.
天父上帝主，我们感谢赞美你。
Your Heavenly Father, we give thanks and praise to you.
主啊，你是向我们说话的上帝。
Because you are God who speaks to us.
感谢你赐下你的信息。
We thank you for giving us your message.
哦，主爱，求主你向我们展现你对我们的心意。
Lord, reveal to us your will in us.
哦，让我们知道我们的生命是多么的。尊荣和宝贵
so that we know how precious, how honorable and, our life is.
让我们知道神啊，你在我们此时此刻这个的环境当中，你究竟要我们做什么
so that we know in our circumstances what you want us to do.
以至于我们不是迷失方向，我们是有确确实实的把握
so that we are not lost and we have the absolute hope.
就是主与我们同在，我们要与他同行。
That is God is with us, and we will walk with Him.
Oh, 主啊，愿主你自己祝福你的话语。
Oh Lord, please bless your own words.
愿你的圣灵让我们在里面重新得力。
And may your Holy Spirit help us to regain strength from them.
也愿我们能够转向你，我们的生命得到更新，得到真正的满足和喜乐。
So that we can turn towards you, and that our life may have the true peace and joy.
奉耶稣基督名求的。
We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，十诫你可能是很熟悉了。
And dear brothers and sisters, perhaps you are very familiar with the Ten Commandments.
有些教会甚至在崇拜，每次崇拜之前要先读一遍十诫。
Some churches even recite the Ten Commandments before they start their service.
让人们知道说，透过耶稣基督十诫当中所讲的一切的事，主耶稣都为我们成就完全了。
So that everyone knows that everything through the Ten Commandments, everything will be fulfilled by Jesus Christ.
可是摩西在颁布十诫之前讲了一段很重要的话，是我们需要留心听的。
But before Moses gave out the Ten Commandments, there are words that he spoke that are very important that we should pay attention to.
因为这段话告诉我们，究竟神要颁布十诫给我们。
Because these words tell us the purpose and the will of God of Him giving us the Ten Commandments.
那么我们一起来念一段这样的这段的经文好不好
？Let's read together these verses.
出埃及记十九章第三到六节这样说。
Exodus chapter 19, verse 3 to 6 says.
我们一起来念哈。
Let's read together.
摩西上到神那里去，耶和华从山上呼唤他说。你要这样告诉雅各家，吩咐以色列人说：我向埃及人所行的，你们都看见了，也看见了我怎样像鹰一样把你们背在翅膀上，带领你们到我这里来。现在 ，verse 5 第五节，现在你们若是实在听我的话，遵守我的约。你们就必在万民中做属我的产业，因为全地都是我的。你们要归我做君尊的祭司和圣洁的国民。这些话你都要对以色列人说。亲爱的弟兄姐妹，在颁布十诫之前，神先重申他跟以色列人的关系。
Before God gives out the Ten Commandments, God first renewed the relationship that He had with the Israelites.
神让我们看到他就是拯救以色列人出埃及的那个上帝。
God allows us to see that He is the God that rescued the Israelites.
接着上帝告诉他们这个关系要进一步的深入。
And then this relationship needs to be deepened.
上帝告诉他们他不只是跟他们只是一次的拯救一个暂时性的他们的神罢了。
And this is not God is not the temporal God and rescue them one off only.
他要和他的百姓有一个永远并且亲密的关系。
He wants to have this intimate relationship with his people eternally.
然而，因为神自己是全能和圣洁的。
Because he is almighty and holy God.
只有当以色列百姓愿意全心来听从谨守神的约。他们才能够有圣洁的生命来亲近这位神。
Only when the people of God wholeheartedly want to draw close to God, then they will have this intimate relationship with God eternally.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，这样尊贵和圣洁的生命是我们在亚伯拉罕生命中可以看到的。
Such an honorable life is seen in the life of Abraham.
亚伯拉罕的生命是非常尊贵的。
And Abraham's life is honorable.
神使亚伯拉罕不论是在埃及还是在迦南。都受那里人的尊重。
Regardless of whether he is in Egypt or in the land of Canaan, he was well respected by the people.
原因在于这些地方的人都看出一件事，就是有上帝与亚伯拉罕同在。
Because in these places, all the people saw that Abraham, God is with Abraham.
除此之外，亚伯拉罕与神的关系是亲密的。
And nevertheless, the relationship that God, Abraham has with God is intimate.
因为圣经说亚伯拉罕是一个与神同行的亲密朋友。
Because he's a close friend who walked with God.
而且你看亚伯拉罕的一生，他是一个真实毫无保留就让神来塑造他生命的一个人。
And you can see that Abraham unreservedly asked God to come to his life.
为此，当上帝透过摩西吩咐这番话的时候
，And when God asked Moses to speak these words,
其实上帝在告诉每个属于他的百姓的事。
Basically, God is telling every people of His.
上帝希望能够亲自的帮助、亲自祝福每个属他的百姓，都能活出一个像亚伯拉罕一样尊贵并圣洁的生命。
And God wants to personally help each and every one of His people to have the life as honorable as Abraham.
并且使他们能每一个每一个上帝的百姓，你我每一个的人都能够活出一个与神同行、亲密无间的生命。
So that every people of God can live out an intimate relationship with God and walk with God.
这是上帝的心意，在整个圣经中不断显明的。
And this is the will of God that is repeatedly revealed to us in the whole Bible.
可是具体要怎么得到这个生命
？But practically or specifically, how should we gain this life?
这就是他们在十诫当中，神透过十诫要告诉神百姓的。
And this is why God, through the Ten Commandments, wants to tell His people.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，不知道你是否想过这样的问题没有
？I don't know whether you have considered or thought about this question.
为什么以色列人在出埃及之前，神没有给他们这个诫命
？Why did God not give the Ten Commandments to the Israelites before they leave Egypt？
为什么神要在他们出埃及之后，在旷野的时候，在准备要进入迦南这个环境，才给他们这个十诫
？Why did God give them the Ten Commandments while they are in the wilderness before they enter the land of Canaan？
为什么之前神不教导他们要怎么做，到旷野了才教导他们啊这个诫命要如何跟从神
？Why did not God teach them what to do beforehand, and only in the wilderness that he started teaching them?
我觉得这个很奇怪。
I feel that this is very peculiar.
因为我觉得这跟我们一般人做事的方式不一样。
I think this is different to how we handle matters.
比如说，平常我的孩子跟我说 ，Daddy, 我要看电视。
And for example, my children would ask me that I want and ask me to watch the TV.
我一般都会先跟他谈条件。
And firstly, I will negotiate conditions with them.
我说你应该把你先做的事，把你要做的作业或者你要练习的东西做完了，我才给你看电视。
I'll tell them that you have to perform all the tasks that you have to do first before you are allowed to watch the TV.
你有对你孩子说过类似的话吗
？Have you ever said similar things to your children？
你小的时候父母有这样跟你讲过吗
？Or when you're young, does your parents say the same？
因为我觉得我小时候是这样被要求的。
Because I felt that when I was young, that was how I was requested to do.
只有当我做到了某些事的某些的要求的之后，我才能够得到恩典和奖励。
Only after I've completed the required task, only then I will have the rewards.
我一开始觉得。
Initially, I thought,
如果我是神，我应该在他们在埃及的时候就跟他们把这个条件、把十诫讲清楚。
I felt that God should have clarified, tell them specifically the Ten Commandments in while they are in Egypt.
等他们能够做到了，我才带他们出埃及。
Only after they have completed the Ten Commandments or they've done what they should, only I will bring them out of Egypt.
可是当我看圣经的时候，我发现不对啊，这跟圣经的背景讲的不一样。
But when I look at the Bible, the circumstances or the scene that was shown was different from what I thought.
因为圣经讲出埃及的时候，也有一个很重要的背景是我们要读的、要知道的。
So when the book talks about the Exodus, there is an important background that we need to read and know.
我们来读这段的经文。
Let's read these verses.
耶和华说：“我的子民，我们一起读啊。子民在埃及所受的痛苦，我实在看见了。他们因受督工的督制所发的呼声，我也听见了。他们的痛苦我是知道的，所以我下来要救他们脱离埃及人的手，领他们脱离那地，到美好宽阔之地，到流奶与蜜之地。”亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，这里上帝告诉我们说，他是因为看到、因为听到、因为知道以色列的痛苦，去救他们。
Here it tells us that God saw and heard the sufferings of the people. That's why He's delivering them.
所以这个的情境是一个紧急的，他对他的百姓那种心痛的、心疼的，要救他们的那个情境。
That's why this setting is an urgent setting, and He's heartbroken. He's heartbreaking to save them.
就好像有的时候我的孩子会突然对我说啊 ，Daddy 有虫子。
And this is likened to how my child sometimes say to me, "Oh, Daddy, there's bugs."
我不可能那个时候站在那里跟他先谈个条件。
And there's
跟他谈条件。
It's impossible for me to start negotiating the conditions with her at that moment.
我不可能说你先做完功课啊，我才帮你把虫子拿走。
Impossible for me to say that you must complete your homework before I.Throw out the bug.
如果你是做父亲的话，你看到你的孩子在那啊虫子，你一定冲进去把那个虫子抓出来，把它。
If you saw your children were shrieking and say, "Ah, bugs!" and you would definitely rush to save them from the bugs.
出埃及记的情景 是一样的。
And this sitting in Exodus is the same.
是神因着对以色列人这个在危机当中显出一个怜悯的爱。
And this is the merciful love that God is revealing when the Israelites are facing crisis.
哇，就像父母哇，在他的孩子在危机的当中的时候，他要立刻去保护、去爱他的一样。
Just as parents often rescue their child immediately because their children was in crisis.
这是无条件并且充满怜悯和恩典的。
And this is unconditional and full of mercy and love.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，很多时候你单独看十诫的话，你觉得这是一个好像要求和条件。
And if you look at the Ten Commandments solely, you think that it's only requirements and full of laws.
可是今天我希望你能够看到，是从整个圣经、从整个出埃及的背景来看，其实神的恩典总是在他的要求之前。
But if you look at the Ten Commandments from the setting of the entire book of Exodus, then you realize that God's grace always walks before His requirements.
而这也是今天这段信息对我们每个人的一个鼓励，就是神对你对我的，对你对我恩典总是在要求之前。
And this is an encouragement to each and every one of us that God's grace always walks before His commands.
对，如今我们在这里做家长的，做教会领袖的，这是一个很重要我们要学的事。
To those of us who are parents and church leaders, there is something here that we need to learn that's very important. Because habitually, we often put requirements before giving grace.
We often put requirements before giving grace.
We often give grace after someone has met the task or requirements that we set.
以至于很多时候我们对人的过程当中，我们好像不断的在要求他们，而我们没有像神一样先听到他们的呼唤声。
That's why in our relationship with others, often we often require of others repeatedly, and unlike God, we never listen to them, their cries.
我们没有先听到他们的需求，他们的痛苦。有些时候我们现在要不断要求人。
We never listen to their needs or their pains and repeatedly just require of them.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，上帝对我们，神对我们尚且如此。
If God treats us as such,
我们况且我们都不是神，我们岂不更要谦卑？我们要学习把恩典行在要求之前吗？
And since we are not God Himself, shouldn't we practice to give out grace before requiring of others?
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，你知道吗？牧师有一个职业病。
Do you know that I have a career illness?
Career illness. Yeah. 很多时候听别人的问题，我会迫不及待的告诉他的问题是什么。
Oh, every time I listen to other people asking questions, telling me stuff, I will hurriedly wanting to tell them what their problem is.
我常常发现我没有去体会，去真正理解他们的挣扎，我直接告诉他答案。
I've realized that I've never really appreciated or truly understand their struggles, and I'll tell them their answers immediately.
我自己做父亲、做丈夫的时候，我是很抗拒别人质疑我的。
And as a father and as a husband, I often resisted doubts.
总是要求我的家人按照我说的做，按照我的计划来做。
I often require my family members to act according or do according to my plans or my goals.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，你生命当中有遇到过这样的人吗？
Have you ever come across such a person in your life?
或者你是否也是有类似的类似的经的跟我一样类似的这种的经历？
Perhaps you have a similar experience as I.
求神帮助我们，真的。
May God help us.
尤其我们这里做父母的，
especially of us who are parents，
当我们的孩子不断成长的时候，
when our children continue to grow up，
我们不能只是在每天在纠正关注，只是纠正他们的问题。
Our focus should not only in correcting their mistakes，
我们也要看到他们的挣扎。
We should also see their struggles。
而同样我们做儿女的，
similarly as children，
尤其你的父母越来越老的时候，
when your parents are aging，
你 要学着体会他们的不容易和他们的良苦用心。
You need to empathize with their difficulties and their well intentions.
恩典要行在要求之前。
Grace should go before requirements.
求神管理我们的心。
May God control our hearts.
尤其当我们在不论是在家里还是在教会做领袖的时候，求神帮助我们。
Regardless of whether we are in church as being leaders or in at home being our home leaders.
因为人总是希望别人听他的。
Because as men, we often want people to listen to us.
很多时候我们没有静下心来聆听和陪伴我们自己的孩子和我们的同工生经过他们的旅程。
And many times we do not quiet down our hearts and accompany our children or our co-workers to go through their sufferings and pain.
总结我们讲的第一个重点。
To conclude the first main point.
上帝是在一个恩典的环境中颁布的实践。
God gives out the Ten Commandments in the setting of grace.
是神先看到他们的痛苦，体会他们的，聆听他们的呼求。
God firstly saw their sufferings and heard their cries.
神先像鹰一样背负并拯救他们脱离了埃及的奴役。
And like an eagle, he carries them and then delivers them out of Egypt slavery.
各位，请你记住，在神的要求之前。神先向你我施恩。
Before God requires of us, God has shown us His mercy and grace.
所以今天不论你看圣经看到的神的要求是什么，请记得神已经向你先向你施恩了。
So today, when you read the Bible, regardless of what God requires of you when you read, remember God's grace has been shown to you first.
接下来我们会看透过整个创世纪。出埃及记以及十诫放在一起，你会发现一个连贯的主题。
And next, when we see the entire book of Genesis and Exodus and the setting that put together, you will find a commonality.
我们之前讲了挪亚的故事。
Previously, we have talked about the story of Noah.
我们讲了亚伯拉罕之约。
And we talked about the Abraham covenant.
如今我们看到摩西颁布十诫这三件的事件当中有一个很强烈的一个的主题。
And now we see the Moses giving out Ten Commandments. There is a common theme.
在牵动他们生命的发展。
And is affecting the development of their lives.
也是你我需要知道才能理解十诫的一个重要的主题。
And this is so important that you and I need to know before we can understand the Ten Commandments.
这个主题可以概括为活在主面前。
And this theme
can be summarized
as living before God.
而并且在圣经不同的人物身上，他是用不同的词来描述这个主题。
And the Bible, when dealing with different characters, using different words to explain or to illustrate this theme.
圣经怎么讲挪亚活在主面前呢？
How did the Bible say about Noah living before God?
圣经说挪亚是个义人，当时是完全人，挪亚和神同行。
The Bible says Noah was a righteous man, blameless in his generation. Noah walked with God.
神怎么说亚伯拉罕活在主面前呢？
How did the Bible talk about Abraham living before God?
神对亚伯拉罕说，我是全能神，你要在我面前行事为人。你要做完全人。
I am God Almighty, walk before me and be blameless.
神怎么说摩西要在他面前，与他同行，活在主面前呢？
How does the Bible illustrates Moses walking before God?
圣经说，在以色列中再没有兴起一个先知像摩西一样，他是耶和华上帝面对面认识的。
And there has not arisen a prophet since in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face.
挪亚与神同行。
Noah was walking with God.
亚伯拉罕行事为人，在神面前。
And Abraham was blameless before God.
到摩西与神是面对面的认识。
And Moses knew God face to face.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹们。
Dear brothers and sisters.
上帝告诉我们一件事情。
God tells us this.
我希望你能够记住。
I hope that you will remember.
神喜悦。神渴望与他百姓有一个独有的同在的亲密关系。
God desires and pleases to have a unique intimate relationship with his people.
所以我们今天在读十诫的时候， 你应该有一个全新的体会。
So when we read the Ten Commandments, you should have a renewed understanding.
我在说神要我们的，神的那个最终的目的是要我们有一个独有的与他亲密的各自独有亲密的关系，记住它。
An ultimate desire of God is to have the unique, intimate relationship with each and every one of us.
因为你如果没有这个，不懂神做这件事要干嘛的话，十诫只不过是所谓的要求罢了。
Because if you do not understand why this Ten Commandments was given, then you think that Ten Commandments is just a law.
可是如果你知道神把这一切的话给我们，是要我们靠近他，跟他有一个独有的亲密的关系的时候，我请你再来读上帝的这段话。
But when you read this, knowing that God wants intimate relationship just with you, and then you will know that
the purpose of God.
That's the purpose of God.
我们一起来念这个十诫的，应该是前三节。
Let's read the first three verses of the Ten Commandments.
你慢慢念来念。
Read it slowly.
去体会神对你说的话，神对你说的话。
Go on and understand what God is speaking to you.
神吩咐一切以下一切的话说，我是你的神，曾经把你从埃及地从为奴之家领出来，除我以外你不可以有别的神。当神除我以外你不可有别，接下来我们看哈，不可为自己做偶像，不可做天上地下地底下水中各物的形象，不可以跪拜他们，也不可侍奉他们，因为我耶和华你们的神是祭血的神。亲爱的弟兄姐妹，主透过他的话在不断的提醒我们的心。
And through God's word, God is constantly reminding our hearts.
没有任何的事情，没有任何的事物能够或者也应该阻挡在我们和神之间，没有任何事情。
There's nothing and there's no matters that can come in between our relationship with God.
也不应该有任何的事物在我们和神中间，不应该有任何的事。
And there should not be any matters that come before our relationship.
甚至神用一个丈夫对妻子的一个的热爱，一个 zeal， 这个热情的表达，让我们感受。
And to the extent that God uses the husband's zealous and passion towards the wife to illustrate his love.
以至于让我们感受到，当神和他的百姓中间有其他的东西或者其他的偶像的时候，他是多么的紧张，多么的难过。
So that so long as anything that comes between our relationship with God, it shows us how devastated our God is.
因为没有一个的丈夫在看到他的妻子和他之间还有另外的一个人有这种亲密的关系 的时候，他不激动 不激动不嫉妒不冲动的。
And there's no husband who will not be nervous or who will not be jealous if there is another man that comes in between him and his wife.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，人在他最亲密的关系尚且如此。
If men are acting as such in their relationship with others, in the wife,
你要知道，在神完美的爱当中，更不能够允许人离开他去亲近和敬拜其他的偶像。
Even more so, God's perfect love does not allow any idols to come in between our relationship with God.
弟兄姐妹们，这是圣经不断让我们看到的事情。
This is what the Bible repeatedly telling us.
也是我今天真心希望你能够得到的一个的这个的一个的信息。
And it's also my sincere hope that you will gain this message.
当我们在神面前的时候，
When we are before God.
当我们在神面前的时候，哪怕一秒钟你在神的面前，一分钟在神面前的时候，
Regardless of a second when you're before God.
请记住，没有任何的事物能代替我们来被他来爱。
There's nothing that can replace us to being loved by Him.
当上帝看到你，他爱你的那一刻，他看到你，他的眼里只有你。
When God sees you and He loves you, In his eyes, there's only you.
就好像我看我的太太的时候，我在旁边，哎，看到另外一个 ，there's no love。
And when as I see my wife, I should not turn aside and look at others.
所以上帝透过这个经文告诉我们说，你知道吗？在神眼中，没有任何的事物能够取代你，让他来。
And this verse is telling us this, in his eyes, there's nothing that can replace you to be loved by him.
神不能够用 Uncle Tan 来取代我的太太，哦，我让我来爱 Uncle Tan 就是来爱我爱，不会有这种事的。
There's no way Uncle Tan can replace my wife to be loved by me.
这是神对我们的爱。
And this is God's love towards me.
同样也没有任何的事物能阻挡神向我们施恩，神要给我们任何的恩，没有东西能够阻挡他。
And there's nothing that can,that can hinder God from giving us His grace and His love.
圣经说没有任何的事物能够使我们与神的爱隔绝。
There's nothing in this world that can separate us from the love of God.
为此，当我们来到神面前的时候
，Therefore, when we come before God,
我们也不能够用任何的事物来代替神。
Similarly, we cannot use other things to replace God.
我们也不应该让任何的事情存在来阻止我们去回应他的爱。
And there's nothing that should be used or to replace us responding to His love.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，我希望我们在读十诫这个经文的时候，我们能够体会神对我们这个爱的渴慕，这种 exclusive 这种独有的这种的爱是多么的强烈。
When we read the Ten Commandments, I hope that we can truly understand and appreciate how exclusive this God's love towards us is.
当你能够体会的神对我们的心意的时候
，When you truly understand God's will in us,
当我们体会到神多么渴望与我们、与你、与我能够一对一这样亲密的同行的时候
，When you truly understand how God desires that one-on-one intimate relationship with each and every one of us,
我们心里可能会有另外的一个问题。
Our hearts perhaps will appear another question.
也是我在看这段经文的时候，哇，我被 shock 到，我被震撼的一个我心中问的一个的问题。
This is when I was reading this verse. I was shocked by this question.
神这么渴慕与我们同行。
If God yearns to walk with us.
神这么渴慕与我们有一个亲密的关系，没有事情能够阻挡神来爱我们。
If God desires such an intimate relationship, and nothing can come between us.
为什么我们没有像神渴慕与我们同行同在的这个的渴慕一样去渴慕与神同行呢
？Why we do not have the same heart or desire towards God, just as how He desires for us?
神说我 I want you so much. 我这么想要得到你，为什么我们没有跟神会说 I want you so much too? 我们很少有我也想要你这样的来回应他。
Why don't we have a great desire to reciprocate the great desire that God has for us? When we are before God, when you use Ten Commandments to reflect, When the Spirit enlightens us, you will discover that there are a lot of things that are constantly replacing the love that we have for Him and come between our relationship with God. Some people love their spouse more than they love God. They obey their spouse rather than God. Some use money and reputation to replace God. So they use most of their time to serve all these things, objects, rather than to serve God.
这是很明显的阻碍。
These are the obvious hindrances.
可是圣经也让我们看到，还有一些隐藏的，我们不容易发现的，是在阻碍我们与神的关系。
But Bible also shows us there are other hindrances that are not so easily detected.
你一定要知道，神不允许任何的事物阻挡我们跟他的亲密关系，对吗
？You have to know that God does not allow anything at all to come.And hinder our relationship with Him.
你应该知道，上帝要求我们爱任何的事情不可以超过爱神，对吗
？You have to know that God wants us not to love anything more than we love him.
所以接下来请你好好来听。
Therefore, next, please listen carefully.
听明白究竟我要讲什么。
Listen carefully to what I want to say.
很多的时候，宗教的信徒，基督徒，会爱教会过于爱神。
Often, Christians or believers love churches more than they love God.
很多人爱教会过于爱神。
Many people love church more than they love God.
很多人爱教会里的人。
A lot of people love the church people.
他去教会是因为他爱这些的人。
He went to church because he loves the people in church.
很多人爱教会的活动。
They love the church activities.
他去教会是因为教会的这些活动吸引他。
He goes to church because all these activities attracted him.
人是很吸引人的。
And people are actually quite mesmerizing to people.
活动也是很吸引的人的。
And activities are also mesmerizing.
有些人爱教会的这种侍奉。
And some people love the church ministries.
因为这些侍奉可以给他所谓的满足感。
Because all the serving ministries gave him fulfillment.
可是很多的时候，这些事情却会阻碍甚至夺去我们对神的那个独一的爱。
But at times, these things or matters came in between our relationship with God.
因为我们应该知道。
Because we ought to know.
我们来敬拜上帝不是因为人，不是因为这些活动，是因为他是上帝，是爱我的上帝，这是唯一的，这是那个最重要的道理。
We came to worship God not because of all these other things, not all these activities. We came before God because he is our God, the one who loves us.
我刚才讲的那些事物有它美好的一面。
There are good side to all these things that I've mentioned.
可是当这些事成为我们偶像的时候，各位
，But when these things become the idols，
它就成为我们与神同行的绊脚石。
It became a stumbling block in our journey with God。
十诫说不要为自己做偶像。
And the Ten Commandments says, "Do not make yourself a carved image."
你说主啊，我也没有雕一个偶像啊。
And you tell God that I'm not carving any image。
可是你心里对人的人对你的吸引力，活动对你的吸引力，多过神对你的吸引力。
The attractiveness of the people and the matters appeal to you more than God Himself.
当我们被这些事情辖制的时候
，When we are limited by these things，
我们是无法靠自己在里面当中释放出来的。
We cannot release ourselves from these constraints，
反而离不开被他们控制。
Instead, we'll fall into deeper control，
因为神知道我们的软弱。
Because God knows our weaknesses.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，请你紧紧的抓住神给我们的这个的信息，就是神不允许任何的事物阻碍我们跟他亲近的关系。神不要，神 hate those things.
Dear brothers and sisters, hold on tightly to this message that God does not allow anything to come between our relationship with Him.
这个世上阻碍我们来到神面前的，就是我们的罪，不是吗？
The things that hinder our relationship with God is sin itself.
就是因为神不要这个的东西来阻碍我们，所以他连他的独生子都舍了，为要得到你我。
For God did not want sin to come between us and Him. That's why He gave us His begotten Son.
以至于今天你我只有在耶稣基督的救恩里面，才能够得到主啊这个同行的生命。
So that today.Only when we are living in the salvation of Lord Jesus Christ Himself that we can walk with God. Because by our own works or merits, we cannot save ourselves from our sins. Only by Jesus Christ Himself can we be saved.
所以亲爱的弟兄姐妹，我请你记住，神要的是你与他同行的生命。我希望你一生作为一个基督徒。紧紧抓住这个的心意。
So please remember that God wants a life that walks with Him intimately in you.
接下来我有几个的问题想问问大家。
Next, I have a few questions to ask everyone.
也是今天我要讲的第三个的重点。
And this is the third main point that I want to say today.
刚才我已经问了大家，为什么神要在以色列人离开埃及到西乃山才这个时候才给颁布十诫呢？
Why does God Why does God give the Ten Commandments when the Israelites reached Mount Sinai?
为什么神要在哇他行了十迹所谓的十灾所谓这些的神迹来对付埃及人的神像？他行了这些之后， 才颁布十诫呢？
After God has performed miracles of the 10 plagues, only after that he gave out the 10 commandments. Why is that so?
你知道十灾是针对埃及不同的所谓的神明的，对吗？
You know that the 10 plagues are to defeat the different, the Egyptians.
Egyptian gods.
Egyptian gods.
可是他做了这么多之后才告诉他们说你不可以干，然他在十诫当中说你不可以有偶像。
But after all that he's done, only then he tells them there's no idols.
为什么神要用摩西来带他们出埃及？
Why did God use Moses to bring them out of Egypt?
为什么神一定要让摩西在何烈山遇到了上帝，荆棘火焰？ OK， 荆棘火焰遇到上帝之后，用有一个这么有这样经历的人来领以色列人。
Why did God appear to Moses in a burning bush on the Mount Horeb?Before he led Moses to lead the people.
最后的一个问题是，既然他们已经在埃及胜过一切阻碍，连法老王都已经妥协了，为什么他们不留在埃及，还要离开埃及？
And since they have overcome all sort of obstacles in Egypt, and even the king, the Pharaoh, has relented, why do they not stay in Egypt? Why do they have to leave?
留在埃及建个国度不更容易吗？
Isn't it easier to build a kingdom if they stay in Egypt?
他们在当时重新所谓的改革革命，自己建立一个新的国度，不更好吗？为什么还要从头开始呢？
Isn't it easier for them to revolutionize and just rebuild the kingdom?
难道神不知道他们在旷野的时候会埋怨吗？
Doesn't God know that they will grumble?
难道神不知道他们其实去埃及挑战更大吗？
Doesn't God know that they are faced with greater challenges if they go to the land of Canaan?
答案是神都知道。
The answer is God knows all this.
神知道这是一个更难的路。
God knows this is a greater difficulty. This is a journey with greater difficulties.
但是他还是让他的百姓离开埃及。
Yet he wants his people to leave Egypt.
还是让他们到了西乃山的时候才颁布十诫。
And he still leads them to Mount Sinai before giving them the Ten Commandments.
因为这是上帝对亚伯拉罕的应许啊。
Because this is the promise that he has given Abraham.
上帝对亚伯拉罕的应许是他要做他们的神，永永远远的神。这些以色列人要做他们神永远的百姓，这是神的应许啊。
Because his promise towards Abraham was that he wants to be the eternal God of the Israelites, and the Israelites will be his eternal people.
Amen. 上帝希望的是这群以色列人。
God hopes that this bunch of Israelites
能够像亚伯拉罕，能够像摩西一样，在他们离开自己旧生活的，离开自己旧生活之后，能遇见神，并且与他同行。
Just like Abraham and just like Moses, God hoped that these people, as they live their old life, can come to encounter God and then walk with God.
为此，上帝在埃及行了那么多的神迹。
And God performed so many miracles in Egypt.
他在告诉每个属他的百姓
was to tell his people,
没有一个神明，没有一个的偶像能够跟他们的神，所谓以色列的神相比，没有。
There's no other gods or other idols that can be compared to the God of Israelites.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，没有一个的神明能够与我们的神相比。Do you get that? 你知道了解这件事吗？
Do you understand this? There's no other God that can be compared to our God.
这是一个多么荣耀，多么激励我们的一个的信息。
Such a glorious and encouraging message.
为此，神希望整个的过程就是以色列民能够重复他们先祖的道路，一生能够与神同行。
So God hopes that the Israelites can repeat the same journey by their ancestors and then walk with God.
神要给他们一个与神同行的经历，以及一个以上帝为他们神的生命。
He wants to give them experience,
与神同行。
Okay, sorry. Experience to walk with God
and 并且以神为神。
And a life that is let God be God.
他让他们去真正的经历神的供应。 在每一步经历神的保护和祝福，因为这个神是他们的神。
And every step in the way, God wants them to experience His provision, His protection, because He is their God.
神在他们到了西乃山的时候，才向他的百姓显明他的心意。
When they reach Mount Sinai, then God reveals His will for them.
你知道上帝的百姓在西乃山面前发生了什么事吗？
Do you know what happened when they reached Mount Sinai?
圣经告诉我们说，那个时候整个的山好像有烟、有云、有雷在那里，在那里大大的响声，你记得吗？
Yeah. Do you remember that Mount Sinai? The mount was covered with a heavy smoke, and there was thunders and lightnings.
然后有声音从西乃山当中对上帝的百姓讲话。
And a sound from thunder that speaks to the people.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，当时西乃山在那里冒烟打雷，就好像一个被放大的荆棘火焰呢。
When the Mount Sinai was covered in great smokes and in thunder and lightnings, it's likened to a bigger version of the burning bush.
荆棘火焰只是给摩西的，对吗
？Burning bush was for Moses alone.
可是西乃山的这个的情景是给每个上帝的百姓一个荆棘火焰的经历。
And this Mount Sinai instead was for each and every Israelite, and is the same experience as Moses had.When he was faced with a burning bush. Because God wants each of his people to have the same experience as Moses and to walk with God just as Moses. Throughout the journey in Exodus, God called his people.
离开过去的依靠吧，离开你过去的依靠，来到我的面前。
Leave your past reliance and come to me.
离开你的旧生活，来跟从我的带领吧。
Leave your old life and come and follow my guidance.
因为西乃山不是出埃及的重点。
Because Mount Sinai is not the destination of the Exodus.
来到神面前，来到神的身边。才是整个旅程的目的。
The journey was to go to God Himself.
这也是我们的目的。
And this is the main aim, and is also our aim.
就是来到神的面前。
Our purpose is to go before God, to God.
神在你生命中赐下的每一件的事情，每个的遭遇，他的目的是希望你能够来到他面前。
All the things that you experience.The aim was to so that the aim was to bring you to God.
先是摩西经历了荆棘的火焰，他的生命得到改变。
Firstly, Moses went came to experience the burning bush, and then his life is transformed.
才是整个以色列人在西乃山经历神的显现和同在。
And then, the people Israelites in Mount Sinai experienced God's presence and revelation.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，神要用那些亲自与神同行的人，顺服神话语的人，成为他的工具。
God wants to use the people that personally come to God to walk with God, to obey His commands,
to lead others.
To lead others.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，这就是离开去得到的重点的信息。
This is the main message of living to receive.
也是整个十诫和出埃及记当中你所看到所有律法当中的一个的核心的精神，离开去得到。
And it's also the main focus of the Ten Commandments and the entire book of Exodus, to live and to receive.
为此，十诫的要求是让我们离开那些的罪。以至于我们能够得到一个活在神面前应有的生命。
The Ten Commandments tell us to leave all the sins so that we can receive the life that we deserve when we walk with God.
上帝的百姓需要离开偶像。
God's people need to leave the idols.
他们需要离开那些假的誓言。
And leave the false oath.
他们需要离开这种淫乱。
And leave adultery.
他们要离开这种杀人和偷窃。
And leave stealing and murder.
他们要离开这些的贪心。
And leave all sort of greed.
以至于上帝的百姓能够真正的在与神同行中得到安息。
So that when the people of God walk with God, they can get the true rest.
离开是为了得到。
To live is to receive.
上帝透过十诫也要我们离开。
And through Ten Commandments, God wants us to leave.
离开罪恶。
To leave our sins.
只有离开罪恶，才能够得到神真正的祝福和平安。
Only when we leave our sins, we can receive the true blessings from God.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，这难道不是也是主耶稣对我们的呼唤吗？
Isn't this also what Jesus Christ called us to do?
主耶稣说，天国近了，你们要悔改。
Lord Jesus says, the kingdom, repent for the kingdom of heaven is near.
主耶稣说，来跟从我吧。
And Jesus says, come follow me.
主耶稣说：“凡劳苦重担重担到我这里来，我就使你们得安息。”
Jesus said, "Come to me, all you weary and heavy burden, I will give you rest."
主说：“来，跟从我吧。”
Jesus said, "Come, follow me."
主耶稣说：“悔改，来，跟从我吧。”
Jesus says, "Repent, come and follow me."
主耶稣说：“我是葡萄树，你们是枝子。”住在我里面的，我也住在他里面，他就结出许多果子。因为离开我，他们就不能做什么。
Jesus said, "I am the vine; you are the branches. Whoever abides in me, and I in him, he that bears much fruit. For that apart from me, you can do nothing."
我们明白吗
？Do we understand?
从旧约到新约，神的心意是不变的。
From the Old Testament up to the New Testament, God's will has never changed.
上帝向我们施恩，才给我们要求。
God first gives us mercies and grace before He requires of us.
神的心意都是让我们活在他面前，与神同行。
God's will is so that we can walk with Him before Him, so that.
Yeah, 可是这一条路必须要经历一个离开才能得到的这个过程。
But this journey requires us to leave so that we can receive Him.
I believe there are
things or men that we cannot, we do not want to let go.
Yeah. 今天你应该知道，很多的是神把我们从当中挪开，让我们离开他们，甚至有些的人或者事情从我们身边带走，其实神是要拯救我们。
You have to understand that God takes away certain people or certain things away from our lives because God wants to deliver us. Because only when we leave these things, we can have a renewed relationship and regain the relationship to walk with God. Dear brothers
and sisters,
today we talk about the spirit of the Ten Commandments.
上帝是一个恩典在要求之前的上帝。
God often gives, God gives grace before requirements or commandments.
整个十诫的心意是希望每一个神的百姓能够和神有一个独有的与神同行的亲密生活。
The Ten Commandments was so that we can have an intimate relationship that walk with God.
所以神不断地呼唤我们，带领我们离开那些旧的生命，阻碍我们与神。
God constantly calls us to have this life in Him so that we can gain Him. Let's pray.
天父上帝，我们感谢赞美你。
Heavenly Father, we give thanks to you and we praise you.
因为你向我们显示了整个律法的这个的心意。
Because you revealed to us your will in the Ten Commandments.
哦，主啊，律法的核心是恩典。
And the core of the Ten Commandments is grace.
律法的结果是祝福并得到基督。
And the result of Ten Commandments is your blessings and to gain you.
主，你要我们，你对我们的爱是没有任何事情能够隔绝的。
There's nothing that can separate us from your love.
哦，主啊，为了让我们能够得到这份爱，你舍了你的爱子耶稣基督。
In order for us to get this love, Lord, you have sacrificed your own Son.
使我们的罪被遮盖。
So that our sins are covered.
以至于主啊，今天神的灵也在运行在我们当中，来感动属神的百姓。
And God's Spirit is now working in us to touch your people.
哦，主啊，在我们患难的时候
，Lord, when we are in hardship,
在我们挣扎的时候
，in our struggles,
求你常常让我们听到你是我们的神。
Please constantly help us to hear that you are our God.
这个世界不是我们的神。
The world is not our God.
人也不是我们的神。
And men are not our God.
外在的这些的所谓的事情都不是我们的神。
All these things in the world is not our God.
哦，我们的职业、我们的家庭，这些都不是我们的神。
Our career or our family is not our God.
只有你是我们的神。
Only you are our God.
只有当你是我们的神的时候。
When you are our God.
我们所做的事，我们所得到这些的祝福，才能合神心意。
All the blessings that we have is pleasing to you.
主要我们当中有很多人离开了自己的家乡。
We know that many of us have left our hometown.
主你带领我们到这里来。
And you led us to here.
不论是学习还是生活。
Regardless whether to study or to live.
主啊，我相信你的目的和圣经是一致的。
And the purpose is coherent with the purpose in the Bible.
就是让我们能够在这里得到你。
So that we can gain God yourself in here.
得到基督。
Here to gain Christ.
奉耶稣基督名求的。
Lord, we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
感谢神赐下宝贵的话语，让我们以诗歌来回应神的话。我们同唱，我的心充满了感恩。Thank God for His word. Let's respond to God's word by singing the responsive hymn. My heart is filled with thankfulness.现在我们举行奉献，让我们预备心来奉献。Let's prepare our hearts and give to the Lord. 会众一同起立，让我们同唱向主献诚歌。请坐 ，Let's be seated。现在我们将要举行圣餐，让我们预备心，同唱预备诗歌，在主圣座前。We will partake of the Holy Communion now. Let's prepare our heart and sing the preparatory hymn here at your table, Lord.
生生世后到处作践，求念你爱真实，我靠近你，尽得我心愿里罪恶死于，得进入你的爱云雨欢聚。 Come there now, Holy Christ, feed us, we pray.
现在请王牧师来主持圣餐。We will invite Reverend Huang to administer the Holy Communion now.
May 上帝祝福每个爱他的人来。预备他的心来领受今天的圣餐。May God bless those who love him, who has abide in him, to prepare their heart and to receive Holy Communion with him. I will read in Chinese. Please follow in English or whatever language you prefer. 我们在主基督邀请所有爱他的人，就是真实悔罪并寻求与人亲爱和睦的人，来到他的圣桌前。因此让我们在上帝面前认罪，也彼此认罪。我们一起来，慈悲的上，我们承认我们没有尽心尽意爱你，我们还不是完全顺服的教会，我们没有照你的旨意行，干犯了你的律法，违抗了你的爱，我们没有爱我们的邻舍，也听不见缺乏者的呼声。求你赦免我们，释放我们，使我们乐意顺服，靠我们主耶稣基督求，阿们。各位请听这好消息，当我们还是罪人的时候，基督为我们死了，神的爱就在此向我们显明了。奉耶稣基督的名，你们的罪赦免了，阿们。荣耀归于上帝，阿们。这时候让我们彼此握手，作为亲爱和睦的记号。好，接下来让我们一同站立。愿主与你们同在。 你们的心当仰望主，我们当感谢我主上主。全能的上帝，创造天地的主，我们无论在何时何处都要感谢你，这本是应当的，也是美好喜乐的。祈求你的灵运行在水面上，你照着你的形象创造了我们，把生命的气息吹进我们里面。当我们背弃你，失去爱你的心的时候，你的爱却永不改变。你的灵降临在先知和教师身上，并恩膏他们宣讲你的道。因此我们和地上的万民以及所有天上的会众一同称颂尊奉主有尊 荣耀的圣名，常常赞美主说：圣哉圣哉圣哉，能力威严的大主宰，天地充满你的荣耀，高高在上何塞纳。奉主名来的是应当称颂的，高高在上何塞纳。弟兄姐妹请坐， Please be seated。主啊，你是至圣的，你的儿子耶稣基督是配得称颂的。你的灵恩高，他将福音传给贫穷的人，宣告被掳的得释放，瞎眼的得看见，叫那受压制的得自由，并宣告你拯救你百姓的日子已来到。主，你医治患病者，喂饱饥饿的人，并与罪人同吃，借着他的主的受苦受死与复活的洗礼，你建立了你的教会，并拯救我们脱离罪恶与死亡的捆锁。主，你又借着水与圣灵与我们立了新约。主耶稣升天的时候，他应许永远与我们同在，正如五旬节当日以圣灵与火为我们施洗。主耶稣为我们献上己身的那一夜，他拿起饼来祝谢了，递给门徒说：你们当拿着吃，这是我的身体为你们舍的，你们当如此行，为的是纪念我。饭后他又拿起杯来祝谢了，递给门徒说：你们都要喝，因这杯是我立新约的血，为你们和众人免罪流的，你们每逢喝的时候要如此行，为的是纪念我。因此我们纪念你在耶稣基督里大能的作为，我们要在赞美与感谢中献上自己，作为圣洁的活祭，与基督为我们所献上的祭联合，共同宣扬信仰的奥秘。我们一起念：基督已经死了，基督已经复活，基督必要再来。主啊，愿你的圣灵此刻浇灌我们，也恩膏所贡献的饼与杯，当我们领受的时候，就如领受基督的身体和宝血，使我们因基督宝血的救赎在世人面前成了基督的身体。求你借着你的灵使我们与基督合一，我们也彼此合一，并且以合一的心服侍世人，直到基督最后得胜降临，我们与他共享天上的盛宴。全能的父啊，借着你儿子耶稣基督，并在圣教会中的圣灵，所有的权柄荣耀都归于你，从今直到永远，阿们。我们一同站立， Please stand。现在让我们以上帝的儿女的身份，一起用主祷文向主祷告。我们在天上的父，人人都尊，愿父的国降临，愿父的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债。不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶。为国度权柄荣耀全是福的，阿们。神羔羊，除去世人罪孽的主，求怜悯我们。神羔羊，除去世人罪孽的主，求怜悯我们。神羔羊，除去世人罪孽的主，赐我们平安，赐我们平安。弟兄姐妹请坐， Please be seated。因为只有一个饼，我们人数虽多，却因同领受这一个的饼，同属一个的身体。我们掰开这饼，是同领基督的身体；我们举起和祝谢这杯，是同饮基督的宝血。 亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，圣餐已经预备好了。Brothers and sisters, we have already prepared the Holy Communion. 圣餐是为基督徒设立的，也让我们纪念主立为我们所立的约。This Holy Communion was prepared and given to Christian, follower of Christ, so we can remember the new covenant of Jesus Christ. 所以亲爱的弟兄姐妹，如果你已经接受过洗礼，你有接受过坚证礼，你明白清楚明白圣餐的意义的话，我邀请你站立，预备自己来领圣餐。So, dear brothers and sisters, if you have been baptized and you have done this confirmation in your church, and you understand fully the meaning of partake Holy Communion, please stand. I will pass the Holy Communion to you, and we will receive Holy Communion together. 之后我们再一起领受圣餐。Okay, please stand if you are ready.好，让我们一同向主献上感恩。永生的上帝，我们为这圣餐感谢你，你为我们献上己身，求你使我们本着圣灵的大能进入这世界，愿意为别人而摆上自己。我主耶稣基督的名祷告，阿们。弟兄姐妹请坐， Please be seated。
接下来是家事报告，我们请王牧师。
好的，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，欢迎大家来参加我们的崇拜。
Dear brothers, welcome everyone to join our service.
我们有一些的新朋友，第一次来我们当中的，我们要欢迎你哈。
With some new friends who are first time with us today, we're welcoming them.
OK, 我们有第一个是 Daniel Robertson.
We welcome Daniel Robertson. May you stand up and let us applaud.
Yeah, welcome. 如果你可以站起来的话，我们知道你在哪里哈。
But you can stand up and know where you are.
Priscilla Chan?
Yes, Priscilla Chang. Priscilla Chang, welcome. Dennis Liao, welcome. And lastly, Muse Chan. Welcome.
好，崇拜之后我们是有爱宴的，请大家留步哈。
And after service, we have a love feast. Please stay behind.
我们会一起享用午餐。
Together, we'll consume the food.
好，我们有一些的报告，请你留心听。
There are some announcements. Please pay attention.
肖牧师会在3月18号来这里有一个的培灵布道会，邀请3月19号晚上有肖牧师的培灵布道会，请大家参加。
On the 19th of March, there is a revival night by Reverend Sue, in Dunedin. So please join us.
Okay, 是在晚上7:30在这间教会哈。
It starts on 7:30 p.m. in our church.
好，第二个，从今天开始就是爱宴之后12:30 to 1:30。
From today onwards, from 12:30 to 1:30,
有诗班练习。
There is a choir, church choir practice.
如果你要参与，有兴趣参加诗班的话，请跟师母报名。
If you're interested to join, please register with our 师母。
或者后面 Auntie Janet 报名也可以。
Or Auntie Janet, who's waving at the back.
Okay. 好，接下来我们鼓励弟兄姐妹们把教会的外面这个停车位尽量保留给那些有小孩或者行动不便的。弟兄姐妹和长辈。
And we encourage our brothers and sisters to reserve the church car parks in front of our church for those families who have young children or elderly who have mobility issues.
Okay, 接下来是我们的营会。
And next, our church camp.
我们有放 video 的吗？ Do we need to play video today? No? No? Okay, 好。那么营会的具体的日期是4月4号到4月7号。
And church camp runs from 4th of April to 7th of April.
我们现在有所谓的这个早鸟优惠价是150纽币，截止日期是3月17号。
We have an early bird fee for 150, and it closes on the 17th of March.
所以你可以现在开始报名了。
And you can start registering today.
那个报名的那叫什么？QR code， 在后面那个 poster 那个来。
And the registration QR code is at the back of the board, bulletin board.
好，同样我们的青团委员会还在举备，还在筹款啊，fundraising 这个筹款。
And youth camp committee is continue to run fundraise.
Okay, 好，接下来还有两项的报告哈。
And two other announcements.
三月八号就是 Coming Friday， 对吧
？This coming Friday on the 8th of March。
7:30在教会，我们会有所谓的大学生青年团契在这里。
And our youth fellowship officially commence in church at 7:30 p.m. this Friday。
Yeah， 这周五，所以你这周五晚上7:30来教会就对了。
Please come to church at 7:30 this Friday。
Okay， 所以我们可以一起有团契。
So that we can have fellowship together。
好，最后一个的报告就是，我们接下来要发一些的鼓励给那些在假期完成读经计划的弟兄姐妹。
And last announcement was to give a token of encouragement to those who have completed the Bible reading during the summer holidays.
好，所以我们请 Uncle Tang 来。
We invite Uncle Tang.
好，当我念你的名字的时候，请你上前来。
When I read your name, please come forward.
我们会有预备这个精美的书签。
We prepare a beautiful bookmark for you.
我们请牧师为我们颁发。
We invite our pastor to gift.
第一位读完的Joshua.
And firstly, Joshua, please come forward.
Lillian.
Lillian.
Acacia.
Acacia.
Timothy Er 应该在 Crutches 吧。Alex.
Alex Low.
Moose.
Pastor.
师母。
师母。
Lawrence.
Lawrence.
Chloe.
Chloe.
还有Katie, Johan, Josiah, Yenika, 一家都不在。
Johan's family is not with us today.
还有Auntie Janet.
Auntie Janet.
还有 我自己最后Darren 因为出门哈我们下一个星期发给他好谢谢大家也谢谢牧师
Thank you all, I'm Pastor
好这就是我们的报告我们接下来一起来唱差遣诗歌 Now let's rise andLet's sing this commissioning hymn together.
Sang the 儿子圣洁无瑕，竟被差遣立坛作为，他上尘土罪恶世界。甘愿成为神的羔羊，真神羔羊，宝贵羔羊，我深爱慕圣洁羔羊，求你宝血来洗净我，耶稣基督真神羔羊。神的爱子被钉十架，受尽凌辱遭人厌弃，谦卑君王头戴金冠，成为牺牲真神羔羊，真神羔羊，宝贵羔羊。我深爱慕圣洁羔羊，求你宝血来洗净我，耶稣基督真神羔羊。
Let's sing in English.
I was so lost, I should have died, but you have brought me to your side.To be led by your staff and rod, and to be called a Lamb of God. Oh, Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, I love the holy Lamb of God. Oh, wash me in his precious blood, till I am just a lamb.
让我们一起来领受祝福 Now let's receive benediction 愿耶稣基督的恩惠上帝的慈爱以及圣灵的感动与我们众人同在直到永永远远 Amen请坐 please be seated. 在奠阅之后我们才结束我们的聚会然后享用我们的午餐 So after the postlude, we will dismiss and enjoy our table fellowship.Let's sing grace, let's 我们做饭前祷告 before we start our lunch. 天父上帝主啊，我们感谢你赐给我们这些食物。Father, we thank you for provide those food. 谢谢你赐给我们这些的这个的桌面上的团契。Thank you and please bless us through this table fellowship. 愿主你的同在和喜乐充满我们。May your presence be with us. May the joy from Christ be with us. 奉耶稣基督名求。In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.